You were found with a recently discharged firearm and a body of a man who'd been shot 3 times.
As you well know, Tony, no one's above the law, but there are circumstances in which prosecution is not in the public interest.
He was armed with a shotgun and a revolver. He confessed to the killing of a police officer earlier that night. He then expressed his intention to kill me. I managed to seize the revolver in the course of a struggle. He attempted to escape. I was unable to pursue him, and I fired at his retreating figure 3 times in the belief that it was the only way to prevent his escape and avoid danger to the public.
That's the biggest load of old bollocks I've ever heard in my life.
Prove it.
Bit out of your depth with this sort of caper, aren't you, mate?
I thought you'd like the good news in private. The Attorney General has decided that the criminal charges against you may be difficult to prove and that they're unlikely to secure a conviction.
I'm sorry, Gracie. I know how much it hurt you to say that.
But they feel it's worth having a go. However, if you were to resign...
Resign?
If you were to resign, they would drop the criminal charges and we would drop the disciplinary charges.
Look, if you want me out, you're going to have to drive me out. I'm not giving up something that's been my whole life.
Well, it's your choice, Anthony. Personally, I think you've got a bargain.
I think everything's there, but please check.
Oh, I'm sure it's all entirely in order. Souvenir for you.
No, thanks. But there is something else I want.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure it's all entirely in order, but I'll check. Thank you, Mr. Clark. I accept your resignation.
You're nicked, my son.
Pleasure.
And I am very surprised he's not appealing to the law lords, because everybody else seems to find him very attractive. He is a man whose skill, dedication, and talent have made him a role model for a whole generation of younger officers, myself included. And now, although you didn't quite make the 50 years, you did manage to make 3 years feel like 50. So, as a mark of our appreciation...
Oh, thank you.
Hooray!
Thanks.
Well, it was either that or a stainless steel spade for digging your allotment.
That's great.
So, what now?
Well, it's a bit early for a nightclub.
Nah. I mean, what are you going to do? Have you sorted something out?
No.
Don't you think you should? Excuse me.
I think she was better off in the DVU.
I don't fancy all that coming between husbands and wives. And it's bleeding fast tracking, eh?
Yeah, but who wants to piss about an intelligence? That's murder.
Huh? Well, I'm supposed to be on leave. I'm supposed to be taking Joyce down to Cornwall, but she doesn't feel up to it.
Is she bad?
Well, I don't know. Up and down, you know.
I've got to leave. I'm sorry.
Listen, thanks for all this.
It's a pleasure. I'll see you later in the week because I told Joyce I'd be around for my lunch. Keep in touch, won't you?
When the dole cube begins to bite, you mean?
Yeah, then.
Right, let's finish these off.
Joyce around.
No, Harry, I won't. It's okay.
Oh, it's all right. Well, you know where we are anyway. Door's always open.
Give my love to her.
What do you want?
I came to your leaving bash. So what are you going to do? Fancy running a pub?
I don't know.
The options are limited. Store detective, security guard. But even they will need references.
Have you come here to wind me up because you're succeeding? You cost me my job and the only woman I gave a toss about.
Bollocks. You needed no help from me to get yourself kicked out. And whatever you thought about Berridge, it was no secret she didn't share the sentiments.
And the video of us, the photos?
You put me in a corner.
You turned my stomach, do you know that?
I did stick my neck out for you.
Oh. Thank you. I mean, really, thank you so much.
You are a pig-headed bastard. But you do have a certain talent.
What is all this?
I have a soft spot for you. Probably because you remind me of me.
And?
I do feel partly responsible for what happened.
And
I have a job for you.
Ah. No. Thanks.
1,000 up front. And another 2 when you find this man. Plus an expenses paid trip to Africa. Philip Skinner.
Uh-huh.
So I just go to Africa and ask, do I?
His address is on the back. It's near Tunis. All you have to do is see him, and if possible, encourage him to talk to my client. Even if the answer is no, you're still 3 grand better off.
And if he agrees to talk?
Another 2.
No. Thanks.
Fair enough. The tapes and the photos. They're the only copies. I owe you that.
Spending some time consulting with my family before I decide how to proceed. I think it likely that we will be taking this matter to the court.
Their solicitor heard from his solicitor yesterday. Skinner, the boy in the picture, was about 17 when it was taken. He was in care, and Tomlinson was his constituency MP at the time. Gentlemen, this is Mr. Tony Clark.
Ah, right. Well, it's a bloody good bash you've pulled us from. John, what's the problem?
Mr. Clark may be willing to help us, but he would like your reassurance that the Skinner affair is kosher.
I thought everyone trusted honest John Deakin. Kosher?
It's your department, Cosmin.
Skinner said he'd been to bed with Tomlinson, who is now junior minister at the Home Office. Mr. Ferguson here thought it made a good story because Tomlinson opposed lowering the age of consent for gays and Skinner was underage at the time of their, romance. Thank you. Anyway, he gave us that photo. We gave him 10 grand, and he said he'd bring us more photos of a more specific nature.
And he buggered off.
Well, why do you want him back?
Because Tomlinson is suing the Ball's office, and without Skinner's evidence, we haven't got a defence.
Well, why don't you go and talk to him?
We don't know where he is.
Yes, well, I've done some preliminary work, and I think we've come up with a lead which will more than justify eventually the money you're paying us. I think Mr. Clark would just like to be sure that your intentions towards Skinner are above board.
Take him to your office. Show him the contract. All we want him to do is to confirm his story.
Show me the contract.
Bloody hell, John.
I know, I'm sorry, he's just a little bit sensitive. Remember, he's gone freelance only very recently.
Yeah, well. Well, I'll get back to that bash, if you don't mind. Well, probably everything worth poking is buggered off by now. I'll see ya.
Yep.
Andy, sorry for calling you so late. Clark will buy it.
Good. Because my boys are getting nowhere.
Skinner won't budge. He's scared.
Well, Clark will reassure him. I'm at the newspaper. Their brief is convincing him, even as we speak, of their benign intention.
Personally, I just shoot the little bastard. I mean, this lot are getting cocky at surviving sex scandals, God knows. But I'm afraid they draw the line at bumping him off.
Well, ours not to reason why, eh?
Absolutely, old son.
Oh, try and make sure your boy goes alone, won't you? There's no point in involving more bodies than necessary.
Don't worry.
Clark doesn't have too many friends left. Good night, Andy.
Good night, John.
Oh, for Christ's sake. No!
What?
You asked me 5 minutes ago.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, use some imagination. From 7 in the morning till 10 at night, your idea of looking after me is to offer me cups of tea.
I'll get it. Hello, Tony.
Joyce.
Hello.
What a nice surprise. A cup of tea?
Great.
Just made it pop.
Must be nice for you, having Harry around all the time. I'll just go and give him a head.
Not good, eh?
I had no idea, Harry.
Wow. Goes in waves, you know? Bad patch. Tunisia? Well, of course you should bloody do it.
I am doing it.
Who's paying?
Newspaper.
Who have you got to find?
A bloke called Skinner.
Oh, look, I've done, ask me. My card's marked already. If I get caught using a computer for private business...
No.
And I'm on leave.
Yeah, Harry, I understand, really. Might be worth asking Mo, though. I mean, she's dipping in and out of this stuff all day long, though.
Bye.
Bye, Joyce. Nice to see you.
He's going to Tunisia.
Now?
Probably tomorrow morning.
Would you like to take Harry with you?
Well, I would as it goes.
Good. That's a deal, then.
I'm not leaving you.
Look, he's driving me up the bloody wall. Take him. He deserves a break.
Don't be stupid, man. I'm not pissing off the Tunisian living you.
Please, Tony.
Look, I'd better go. Bye, Joyce.
Bye, Tony. It is Tomlinson's business what he does in his own bed.
Why doesn't he just admit he's gay?
Oh, it's that easy, is it? It was 12 years before I felt strong enough to go public. Maybe he just doesn't feel that strong.
Yeah, but he shouldn't say men can't go to bed together at a certain age, having done it himself.
No, but nobody has the right to go parading someone's sexuality across everybody else's bloody breakfast table.
Yeah, well, a contract's a contract.
Yeah? And just who exactly is your contract with?
I told you, the newspaper. Listen, you couldn't check Skinner out in the files for me, could you?
I am still a police officer. Foxtrot Oscar.
Harry.
Yeah.
What is it?
Connor come in?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Think I might get
yeah,
myself.
All right.
I mean, are you really going to wear it?
Will you shut up?
Right.
What do you want?
Well, I was wondering how long you were going for, you know.
Maybe a couple of days, maybe longer. Why, do you want to come?
Not really, no. But Joyce is serious. She wants me out of the house. As long as it's all right with you.
I don't believe it. That's brilliant. Brilliant!
Yeah, but... I mean, when I need a visa or something like that.
No.
Ah.
Well?
What?
What do you think?
It's too hot, I can hardly breathe. And why we have to pay three times as much for a car without a bleeding roof, I don't know.
That's the point!
It's a hell of a lot of bloody money.
All right. Hello, Mo.
Hello, Joyce. Come in.
Afraid Harry's not here. Come on, Jack.
Jack?
That's all right, because it's you I came to see.
What's Harry doing?
Oh, he's with Tony Clark in Tunisia.
Is he?
Needed a break.
Harry, this is the private sector. No more fiestas. You get the most expensive car and you drive straight to the most expensive restaurant. It's called expenses.
All right. I just wonder what the newspaper editor's gonna say when you hand him a receipt for a car with air conditioning and no bloody roof. Is this the most expensive hotel?
No, I just fancied a bit of local colour.
Mr. Clark?
Yeah.
Welcome.
I see what you mean.
There you are. A bit of traditional Tunisian for you.
Thanks, Mo. That was delicious.
Well, some people just have a knack with a microwave button. Others don't.
Harry doesn't.
I can't believe Tony Clark would just take him away like that.
Oh, I wanted him to go. I needed some time on my own.
Well, all the same, Clark is selfish.
I told him to go. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm tired. You've no idea what it's like when you know that you're dying and everyone else is trying to pretend that you're not. It's exhausting.
I understand.
I am dying.
I know.
Thank you. I feel better for that. Will you look after him?
You know I will, Joyce.
Oh. Excuse me. Hello? Sweetheart,
what?
Don't shout!
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Isn't it incredible, eh? I'm in bloody Africa.
You're right.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. It's all very Arabic, it's too hot, and I'm bloody missing you.
Harry, you are an idiot.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Look, what's your number there?
It's all right, I'm on expenses.
No, never mind about expenses. This is a private call. We'll pay.
It's 270.
270.
149.
149.
Yeah.
I'll call you right back, all right?
Right.
Bye.
Oh, well?
Yeah. Yeah, they're like a couple of little boys in a sweet shop.
No change there, then.
Should be it. That was easy.
What?
$3,000 just walked out that garden.
Are you sure that's Skinner?
Yeah, just like his photo. Let's go and have a word with him.
Gov?
What?
What about his friends?
Ah.
He's running out of patience.
Well, I'm sorry, but his offer isn't good enough. We'll talk later.
You've got until tomorrow morning.
Right.
Oh, you prick.
What are you going to do about Skinner?
One moment,
please. Hello.
Telephone, Mr. Clark.
Hello?
Gov, it's Mo.
Mo, you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, fine. Look, I've seen Skinner's file and there's plenty there. Convictions for drugs and burglary, but they're into him for porn and cocaine as well.
It's a standard CID fit-up.
No, not just CID,
but special branch as well. You are totally out of your depth.
Mo, don't worry. I've already seen him.
Already?
Yeah. How's that for $3,000?
Is he alone?
No, he had a couple of blokes with him.
Kidnappers?
He didn't look very kidnapped to me.
Mo, don't worry. I can deal with it.
You just keep Harry out of it. You shouldn't have dragged him in the first place, especially since you're working for Deakin.
How do you know that?
It's all over the bloody file.
My name?
No, your name isn't there yet, but it soon will be, and so will Harry's. And if word gets back...
It won't.
Oh, no. This is Deakin, remember? I'm not risking home or the office. I'm ringing you from a hotel. You are a bloody fool.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay. Bye.
Your wife?
No. Oh, no. Colleague.
Scottish?
Yes.
I like Scottish.
Oh. Well, actually, I've got a wee bit of Scottish in me. Would you like a drink?
I don't drink.
I meant, like, take you for a drink.
No, thank you.
This is a joke. First I get sunstroke, pretty soon I'm gonna get seasick.
You're on an all-expenses-paid oboe in the Mediterranean, and all you can do is moan.
What was Mo on about?
Giving us some information about Skinner.
Good. She's agreed to help him.
Not exactly. Doesn't really approve of us being here.
And she? Why?
Know what she's like.
How did the newspaper get hold of you? Deakin? And Mo knows? No wonder she's pissed off.
Here he comes.
Talk.
Bill, we're not gonna hurt you.
You're lucky we might even save you.
No, I'm sorry about the photos. No. I'm desperate.
Get on the bloody boat. Stop pissing about, will ya?
Stay away.
Get off him.
Wait, no, get off.
Harry, would you mind not leaving me behind?
I don't know how to drive the bloody thing.
Don't hurt me.
Will you shut up, please? We've got a crisis here.
Oh, here we go, here we go.
Harry, it's very deep out here.
I'm coming. I just don't want to get any of the sharks caught in the propeller.
Look, I want to go in.
You're all right, we only want to talk.
Yeah, why out here?
Couldn't agree more.
We're just trying to get you away from your gangster friends.
Yeah, well, you certainly managed that very well, didn't you? Can't go back now.
They're not gangsters, they're special branch.
You what?
I haven't agreed to anything.
Oh, shit.
Nice one, Gov.
Gov? Well, not the police as well.
Not exactly.
What's going on?
Good question.
We're here to find out whether you're prepared to confirm the story.
Who sent you?
The newspaper.
Oh, I see. Are they making me an offer?
Well, of course. Why else would we be here?
And if I don't accept, you'll kill me, is that it?
Don't be ridiculous. Look, Phil, I'm sorry you were shaken up. We must have put the shits up here, but we're not killers or anything like it. You're safe. If you want to go back now, he'll take you.
Are they really offering money?
Of course.
Deakin? Oh, Tony. You have? Well, I didn't really want them hijacked, just talk to. I'm afraid my boys have nicked Skinner from your boys. Asshole?
Yes, you're a total asshole. Look, if you knew where he was, presumably you also knew he had special branch with him.
Absolutely no idea at all. This has come as a big surprise to me.
All right, listen, he wants to know what the deal is.
$30,000.
If you'd ask for 50, then maybe you'll get 40.
Good idea. Half paid in advance into that account.
Tomorrow morning.
Right.
Word in Eureka.
I'm going now.
This is Joyce?
No, not really. She's okay, but I want to be with her.
Yeah, I understand.
And I gotta tell you, I'm not happy about messing with Deakin.
No, well, I needed the work.
Yeah, I know, but I'm paying off witnesses. I mean, I'm not making any judgments, you know? I know how hard it's been. I know you're bitter. And...
Harry, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You bloody are. Anyway, as the plane leaves tonight, I've ordered a taxi.
Shit. Oh, shit.
Skinner!
Can I help you? Who's your boyfriend?
He's here of his own free will.
And I'll leave it out.
You want to stay with him?
Yeah.
Big mistake. They're going to kill you.
Yeah, I'll risk it.
Bye-bye. As for you, Sonny.
Sonny? Sir, surely I'm a taxpayer. I employ you, but respect, please.
Shall I call the police?
No, it's all right. Bill and Ben are just leaving.
No guarantees.
40K plus your 20 is some bundle to end up with nothing.
I agree, but from what I hear, no one could guarantee Skinner's behavior in any direction. Now, we've found him and opened up communication. Quite an achievement. Well worth the 10 you've paid me. They're booked on a flight tomorrow morning, and for the extra 10, we'll bring him home.
I had a string of foster parents. Tomlinson was kind of like a dad in some ways.
So why'd you rat on him?
I was skint. He told me to piss off. So I went to the papers.
Took money and did a bunk.
I wasn't that simple. I got a visit from the police. I suppose they were. I never asked to see any ID. They told me there was a whole load of things they could do me for. Some real, some imagined. I got scared and ran.
Why Tunis?
I thought I'd choose somewhere with lots of dope and no extradition.
Like an arsehole, I picked the only place in Africa where weed is harder to get than golden shred marmalade. But the stuff you do get, it's the best.
So what was it like then? A police force?
Police service now. Less aggressive.
I mean, it makes you think, doesn't it?
What?
All those generations of people carting stuff from all around the world. Cutting stone, building.
Mm. May I? Sorry.
They're all working to make this great city. Carthage, you know? And now it's all in ruins.
Mm.
And now it's about 10 miles over that way. And now it's just all ruins. And they're like this lot here, dead and forgotten. And all that stuff they worked all their lives for, it's just gone.
Back.
Thought I'd surprise you. Cup of tea. G&T.
Come on.
Come on in.
What? You stay in it. Come. Stay in it.
I'm sorry I woke you up, love.
You haven't.
Sorry.
Oh, Joyce, love.
I want. I'm so tired, I don't think I can take it anymore.
Why didn't you tell me this is what you want, didn't you?
Because you tried to stop me. I'm halfway there. Please. Oh, just cuddle me, H. Be all right. sorry.
It's all right. I mean, I understand, you know. I love you.
Yep. Yep. Okay. Where have you come from?
Paris.
And before that?
Tunis.
Bags on here, please. New watch? Did you buy that in Tunis?
No, it was given to me as a present before I went.
Got the receipt?
No, I said it was a present.
Right, gentlemen. If you'd like to undress, please.
What?
Don't be difficult, sir. Just do what I say.
Look.
Just do it.
Gentlemen, how nice to see you. Stanley, will you take Mr. Skinner through to the other room? We want to have a word with Mr. Clark here.
Sorry.
Well, we hear you used to be a superintendent. You resisting arrest? Thinking of striking a police officer? Obstructing an officer? Resisting arrest again, sir?
Jack, Mr. Taylor's coming.
All right, Jack. He was cutting up rough, sir.
I'm sure.
Skinners?
Yes, sir.
All right, you're free to go. Thank you, boys.
What you don't seem to realise, Phil, is that this whole thing began because you made a rather silly statement to the newspaper.
Yeah, but I want...
Thousands and thousands, hundreds of thousands of pounds have been spent. Now then, we found a rather disgusting collection of videos in your flat and an amount, what my drug squad friends refer to as dealer quantities, of a substance that appears to be cocaine.
You can.
We can, Phil. We can. And much, much more. But we also found a large quantity of money.
What?
Wait a moment. 20,000 in used notes. Now, the deal on the table is that we will disappear the videos and the drugs and return you the money. Attractive, eh?
Hello, sir.
I'm sorry.
Doctor's in here.
Hello. Superintendent Tyler, I'm Harry's boss.
Dr. Rosner, Mr. Naylor, would you mind if the superintendent and I had a quiet word? I'm sorry to have to call you out, but this is awkward. It appears to be suicide.
Has Mr. Naylor confirmed that?
I haven't asked him. It seemed kinder not to. She's been dead several hours, and no amount of probing will bring her back.
Quite.
But you'll understand that although I can certify life extinct, I can't sign a death certificate.
Oh, yes, I suppose so. But, I mean, she was terminally ill, wasn't she?
Yes, but sadly, that doesn't really change things. I was only phoned 30 minutes ago. She's been dead several hours, maybe since yesterday. Had he called sooner, we might have saved her life.
There'll have to be an investigation.
Superintendent, I know that. I didn't say I don't want to sign a death certificate. I said I can't.
It won't be very pleasant for Harry.
Believe me, I'm aware of that, but there can't be one law for the police. And one for the rest of us.
No, of course not. It's just that,
It's all right, sir. The doctor's right.
Excuse me, sir.
I'm trying to marry Nigel.
Joyce took an overdose.
So were they your sleeping pills or Joyce's?
Harry.
Do you not think this could wait?
Yeah, good idea. My office tomorrow, 11 o'clock.
See you.
Yeah, I'll see if my wife's on. Tea?
Yeah.
When did she do it?
Yesterday, Harry found her when he came back from your little jaunt. Graves wanted to know where he was and why he'd been away. They're following the investigation as if it could be murder. So they'll find out Harry was in Tunisia and what he was doing. And he'll be kicked out.
Are you blaming me for this?
Good luck, mate. See you at lunchtime, huh? Mo, listen, I'm sorry about taking her to Tunisia or all that.
It's all right. I'm sorry about yesterday. It wasn't the right time.
See you later.
We did what we were contracted to do. I told you, there were no guarantees.
Yeah. Well, apparently someone's paid Skinner a large amount of money to say that he never suggested there was any sexual activity with Tomlinson, just friendship. Fortunately, the increase in circulation has more than covered the cost of the out-of-court settlement suggested by their solicitors. Bloody irritating, though. The Mirror's doing a story on their friendship just to piss us off.
How a young MP helped me get my feet back on the ground.
I think there's a certain pleasing symmetry about it all, don't you?
Yeah, I suppose managing to keep both feet firmly either side of the fence is some sort of symmetry.
The real talent lies in not getting your balls caught on the barbed wire.
You're a sly bastard.
Well, I wouldn't put it quite like that, but I do know what side my bread is buttered on. Talking of which...
You're still an arsehole.
I hear you took Harry with you. Was that fun?
You don't know, do you? Joyce is dead.
Did you have any idea she might attempt suicide?
No.
You never discussed it?
No.
And why did she do it?
Because she was dying a slow and undignified death anyway.
So she was quite ill?
Very.
But in reasonably good spirits?
No, she was very unhappy.
This is the bit I don't really understand, Harry. She was terminally ill and in very low spirits, and you went on holiday. You say you were not there when she took the overdose, that in fact Joyce thought you were on holiday in Tunisia. Then you happened to come in just after she'd taken the drugs. Can you explain? The interview is not over.
Listen now, twat.
That's your job. That's your job. Out the window.
Harry! Apologise.
Why should I? I mean, who the bloody hell does he think he is?
Harry, I think I should be the one to apologize. I was insensitive. I'm sorry. I won't report this.
Well, fair dues, but I'm still happy.
Harry, no. You're an excellent copper.
Please, Harry, will you calm down and think?
I've already thought about it. I'm too old to be taking orders from people 20 years younger than me.
Yeah.